Hello friends, I am Dr. Tanmay Mansal. I am again there with you with a new video about the coronavirus. As we have talked about coronavirus in detail in our last videos, today I will tell you about the few questions which are there in mind of everybody about the coronavirus and its infection. So first of all, I will tell you what is coronavirus. Coronavirus is a group of viruses which affects both humans and animals, but in humans, it commonly affects respiratory system. In most of the cases, it gives mild symptoms or common flu. But if severe symptoms are there, it may give right to respiratory distress, respiratory arrest, and may lead to death of the person also. Second thing is, what is COVID-19? So friends, COVID-19 is an infection caused by coronavirus. The full form of COVID-19 is Coronavirus Disease 19 or 2019. Because the virus infection was detected first time in Wuhan city of China in December 2019. So because of 2019 December, it is known as COVID-19 disease. So COVID-19 disease is caused by coronavirus, which started in December 2019 in Wuhan city of China. And from there, it is spread to whole of the world. And now whole of the world is having pandemic of corona and is fighting with this infection and trying its best to get rid of this infection. Next thing is, what are the symptoms of COVID-19? So friends, COVID-19 symptoms differ from and range from mild symptoms to severe illness. In most of the cases, means about 80% of people, they recover after getting mild symptoms only. But out of every 5 persons, at least 1 person is there who suffers from severe illness and may get into serious disease, which may cause respiratory distress, patient may need ventilator, and finally it may lead to death of the person also. So the symptoms of the coronavirus infection are classified into 3 types. First is common symptoms, second is less common symptoms, and third is severe symptoms. Common symptoms include dry cough, fever, and tiredness. Dry cough means the cough should be differentiated from cough of coronavirus infection and other infections, because dry cough can be due to our allergy or due to acidity also. But if cough is having sputum elongated, it definitely is not corona and is due to some other infection. But in case if you are getting dry cough along with fever, which may be low grade or high grade, and tiredness, it may be due to corona. In addition, if you have got one or other less common symptom also along with this, you may have or you are having chances of getting corona infection, but it doesn't mean that 100% or definitely you have got corona infection. So you have to be aware about the symptoms, but you should not be afraid of the symptoms. Less common symptoms include diarrhea, conjunctivitis, headache, body ache, sore throat, or loss of smell or taste, or discoloration of toes or nails. But it doesn't mean that if you have got these symptoms, you definitely have got corona infection only. They may be part of some other infection also. Besides this, you may have rash also over the body sometimes. In severe symptoms, if we talk about, severe symptoms include chest discomfort, respiratory distress, feeling of tightness in chest, or heaviness in chest, or loss of speech, or loss of movement. If you are getting any of the severe symptoms, you need to report to the healthcare personnel immediately so that timely action can be taken, so that you are protected from severe symptoms or severe illness, because it may lead to death of the person also. Next question is, how coronavirus infection spreads or COVID-19 spreads? So friends, COVID-19 infection spreads through droplets. It is known as droplet infection or fomite-borne infection. The person who are affected, their secretions from nose or mouth, their saliva, while sneezing, coughing or talking, is transmitted to other persons, or it may get transmitted to cut surface of some person's body. From there, it can enter the body and give rise to symptoms. So you have to maintain social distance so that you can avoid getting or catching corona infection. Next question is, what should a person do if he gets COVID-19 symptoms? and when should he take medical care. So I told you previously that if you have got mild symptoms or less common symptoms, they can be treated at home itself. But if you have got severe symptoms, you need to report immediately to the healthcare personnel so that timely action can be taken. Next question is, can COVID-19 be caught from a person who has no symptoms? Yes. A person who has no symptoms may also give you corona infection, because you don't know whether the person in front of you has got corona infection or not. Because it is not necessary that a person who gets infection will get symptoms also. Or maybe that he will get symptoms in next 2-3 days or 4-5 days. And or maybe that he is having mild symptoms only, which are not evident at present. So think or treat everybody as if he is having corona infection, and you have to protect himself, yourself from him, so that you will get less chances of getting infection. Next question is, how corona spreads? As I told you earlier, it spreads through droplets or secretions over a person who is infected with coronavirus. Okay. Next question is, can a person who is not having any infection or symptoms still transmit that disease? As I told you, yes. He may be during the incubation period, or he is having mild symptoms, so he can definitely transmit that disease to you also. Next question is, how can we protect ourselves and others from a person who is infected? For that, I want to tell you that best way to protect yourself from infection from other persons is social distancing. You have to maintain a distance of at least 1 meter from others so that there are less chances of contracting infection. Next is, wash hands. Avoid repeated touching of your nose, eyes or face or mouth with your fingers. Don't go out unless very necessary. Stay home, stay safe. Even if you have to go out, use mask. Don't touch all surfaces unnecessarily, and if accidentally also you have touched the surface, don't touch your nose, face or eyes with those hands. After getting home, wash your hands immediately. You have to remove your footwear outside the house itself. Wash your hands, face, take a bath, replace your clothes. Don't touch anybody, don't talk to anybody at home. Maintain a distance of at least 1 meter at home also, till you clean everything, so that you will not transmit the infection to others also at home. Next question is, what should I do if I have come in close contact with someone who has COVID-19 infection? So friends, if you have come in contact of a person who is already infected, or you suspect that he is infected, then in that case you have to quarantine yourself. Quarantine means you are not having any infection, but you have come in contact with a person who has got infection, or he is potentially having an infection. So you have to isolate yourself at home, away from others, so that in case you have got infection, you will not transmit the infection to others also. Maybe that you will get symptoms in next 5-6 days. It can cause symptoms even up to after 14 days. But till then, you have to isolate yourself. This is known as self-quarantine. In case you have got infection 100% from a person, you are sure that you have got the infection, in case that case also you have to isolate yourself from others at home itself. This is known as isolation. So self-isolation is if you have definitely got the infection from other person, or you have got symptoms. In that case, you are keeping yourself away from others. Whereas quarantine means you have separated yourself from others when you have a chance that you are not sure, but you have a chance that you have caught the infection from others. Third is distance. So distance means you have to maintain at least a distance of 1 meter from others, so that you will not counter the infection from some other potentially infected person. Next question is, what should I do if I have no symptoms, but I think I have got exposed to COVID-19? As I told you, even if you have no symptoms and you have got exposed to the infection, you have to isolate yourself. That is known as quarantine. Next question is, can children or adolescents catch COVID-19? Yes. People are having a false believe that only elderly people or more than 60 age people can get COVID-19 infection. This is not true, because COVID-19 can affect anybody, any age, any sex, whether it's a child, young adult, adolescent, or middle age or elderly. And we don't know who is going to get severe symptoms, who is going to get mild symptoms, who is going to die of the disease. So better is to avoid catching infection itself, because we don't know how much our immunity is going to work against this coronavirus infection. Once you have got infection, you are prone to get any range of symptoms, whether it's mild or severe, or any person can die because of this disease. So best is to avoid getting this infection itself. Next question is, what can I do to protect myself and prevent the spread of disease? The best thing is stay home, stay safe, use soap or any other hand rub, alcohol based hand rub, to clean your hands, wash your hands. If you think your hands are really dirty or soiled, you have to wash your hands with soap and water. But you think that you have touched some contaminated surface and you are outside the home, you can just use hand rub, which is alcohol based. But try to use soap and water as much as possible instead of alcohol based sanitizers, because alcohol based sanitizers can give you skin irritation, skin allergy, and later with excessive use it may give rise to skin cancer also. So better to avoid alcohol based sanitizers every time. It is best to use soap and water every time to clean your hands, your body surfaces, and your face. Next thing is, what can I do if is there any vaccine or drug or treatment for COVID-19? So friends, till date there is no vaccine available which can work against COVID-19. People ask whether influenza vaccine or pneumococcal vaccine will work against COVID-19. So the answer is no, it will not work at all. Is there any medicine available against COVID-19? No. A lot of trials are going on. Like people are using hydroxychloroquine, they are using vitamin C tablets, they are using ivermectin tablets. But till date, no drug has proven its efficacy that yes, documentarily it is effective against coronavirus. Everything is in experimental phase only. Will antibiotics work against coronavirus? No. Because coronavirus is a virus, antibiotics are for working against bacterial infections. Next question is, will medical mask protective, or whether to use medical mask or not? So friends, I want to tell you, yes, masks basically are for healthcare professionals. Globally we are having shortage of masks, but if you cannot avoid going outside, you have to go to a place where lot of people will be there. You have to, yes, yeah, you have to definitely use masks. There are several types of masks available. One is N95 mask, one is 3-ply mask, one is with nose clip, without nose clip, with valve, without valve. So you have to take a mask which is having nose clip, which is not having any valve. They will protect you better. But better to stay at home, and if you have to go out and you cannot avoid it, definitely you have to use mask. Next question is, how long does it take to develop COVID-19 symptoms after exposure? So commonly after 5 to 6 days people get symptoms, whether it's mild or severe, but it may take up to 14 days time to show its first symptoms. Next thing is there any connection between COVID-19 infection and animals? I want to tell you that the first infection that started in China, in Wuhan city, was said to be due to transmission of virus from bats to humans. But from animals like cats, dogs, till date there has not been seen any case or reported any case. However, minks have been seen to transmit infection in few cases, but from dogs or cats it has not been seen to transmit to humans. Although from the infected individuals it has been seen that the pets like cats, dogs, tigers do get infected, but from them whether it comes to humans or not, it has not been seen till date. Next question is, how long does the virus survive on a surface? So friends, virus on any surface is said to survive to the maximum of 9 to 14 days. But in general, on plastic surface or stainless steel, it survives up to 72 hours. Whereas on copper surface, it survives up to 4 to 5 hours. And on cardboard sheets, it survives up to 24 hours. So better is to avoid touching the contaminated surface, because you don't know definitely that for sure the virus has gone after 4 hours or 5 hours. So better to avoid touching all the surfaces repeatedly. And even if you have touched, wash your hands. Don't touch the your eyes, nose, your face with your contaminated hands. Next question is, how to go to grocery shop safely? If you have to go to grocery shop, use mask, maintain a distance of at least 1 meter, maintain social distancing, don't touch surfaces everywhere, don't touch your nose, mouth and face, try not to talk to everybody, avoid talking, and finish your tasks fast and return home. After returning home, you have to remove your footwears outside the home, you have to clean your hands and face thoroughly with soap and water, you have to take hot water bath, you have to change your clothes and wash them immediately so that nobody at home will catch the infection from you. Next question is, how to wash fruits and vegetables? You can wash them with the help of soap and water, but you can use chlorinated water also so that the infection will be cleared from the vegetables and fruits. Although till date there has not been seen any infection which has got transmitted through fruits and vegetables. So friends, the last question is, can I catch COVID-19 infection from fecal matter of somebody who is having the disease? So friends, I want to tell you, although it has been seen that fecal matter of the individuals who are having infection or disease, they do shed coronavirus in their fecal matter, but till date there has not been seen any case of virus transmission through fecal matter or water in any case. So friends, finally I want to tell you, the best thing in coronavirus infection is, if you stay at home, you are protected from virus to a great extent. So stay home, stay safe, maintain hygiene, wash hands, don't shake hands, do namaste, and wash your hands with soap water or alcohol based disinfectants, maintain social distancing, and don't talk much or touch the surfaces everywhere if you have to go out. If you like our video, do not forget to subscribe, share and comment on our channel. Thank you.